Hello, everybody, and welcome back to my channel, Leilani of Barbados. I feel very regal.
So today we're going to talk about the Jubilee, and I'm going to give you all the conspiracy theories and all these things. But for a fact, we know that Harry and Meghan are pissed. In fact, Harry even wants an apology. Not sure from who, but he felt very pushed to the side. He felt like they were dismissive of him. I think, in fact, they even left early. They cut their trip short. They never got to meet with the Queen, apparently. I guess they never even had Lilibet's birthday party, which they were trying to put out in the press that was going to happen. I guess Harry's not really used to being put to one side. He's always been right up there with William for most of his life, so it must have been difficult. However, I would venture to say that it's likely to be more about Meghan being upset that she wasn't able to get her Netflix content. She wasn't able to document it. She came all dressed and all ready, you know, to get some footage, and they probably made it quite clear to her from the get-go that that wasn't happening. And also, they were booed, not upon entering the chapel for the church service, but upon leaving.
Church bells drowning out the odd boo as they departed.
So I can imagine that that might be her real grievance, because for all purposes, she still got to be part of it in some way. And about meeting with the Queen. So they didn't get to meet with the Queen. I mean, are you surprised? I'm not. Why should somebody like the Queen receive you when you have already put all these things out here about her? I think, in fact, it's protective. It's preventative. Suppose you come in there and meet with her and then go back on Oprah and say, "The Queen said to me, you smell bad. Is it because you're black?" You know, she could really make up anything just like she did last time. Why would the Queen put herself in that position? It's a defense mechanism. Also, from a moral standpoint, why should somebody like the Queen give you her time when you've done that? A lot of people, I mean, that is a highlight of their lives to meet the Queen for the first time. I've heard stories of people meeting with the Queen and it's like, and it's more important than the birth of their first child. My therapist even was telling me a story about thinking she was going to meet the Queen and it sounded like the highlight of her life. Apparently, my therapist was in this place where there was a possibility of the Queen being there and the corgis were there. And when she saw the corgi, she was like, yes, the Queen. But unfortunately, it was just the corgis that were there and not the Queen. Oh, by the way, yes, I have a therapist. I highly recommend it. I think everyone should have one. But that is still to say that the Queen is a human being just like the rest of us. And we cannot be made to get along with everybody in our family, our extended family and our in-laws if they're not deserving of it. I think it was on Sunrise Australia that they said, you can choose your friends, but you don't choose your family.
Like, some people just don't get along. It's not unheard
maybe
of.
They won't.
Yeah, that's right. It happens in families all the time.
You pick your friends, you can't pick your families. Yeah, that's right, you pick your friends.
So do what you gotta do. Protect yourself against the haters. Why should the Queen give you, especially on her Jubilee, when she has all these events and all this energy to give to other people who are deserving of it? Why? If I were the Queen, I would have been like, I'm lying down. I'm in the bathroom. I'm in the shower. Sorry, I'm sleeping. Anything to not spend my energy on these two people, okay? That is what we are going to get into. How did this all pan out? Well, let's go. Anyway, let's just jump right into this story, okay? Lilibet's picture has been released. I'm gonna talk about the children today. Louis, he's my spirit animal. He's so brave. Okay, where should we start? Let's start with Louis. He's so brave that he should be the next national hero of England. So should Catherine, because as a Caribbean mom, the hot slap is a thing. And I know we don't promote violence in the civilized nation of the United Kingdom, but coming from Barbados, there's one hot slap and it's so quick. It's so quick that you can just not even see it, or you don't even know if you saw it. Shout out to Carlton A1 supermarket. That's a supermarket in Barbados. It's not frequented by tourists as much. It is definitely a local supermarket, not sponsored, obviously. But if they want to sponsor me, I would like to buy some lamb neck from them next time. My husband went there with me, and in the checkout line, he saw in real life a hot slap, which is like, it's so quick and it's so hot that the child doesn't even cry. It's like, well, the Caribbean child is not crying. I saw a lot of opportunities for hot slaps here. This little boy did the most. And I love him. He enjoyed it to the fullest. Here he is, like, just touching his mother. You know, when you put your hand to someone's face like that. Oh, and the other hand. He's good with the jabs, though. Because he's like, I can do it this hand. I can do that hand.
nope, I can do that hand, I can do that hand. Oh, I'll silence you both ways. And the other children are just completely oblivious to it. Oh, he's so sweet though. He was vibing with the music. I found it extremely entertaining. The sweet moment where he goes into his grandfather Charles's arms and he behaves a lot better, which lets you know how important grandfathers are to children. Papas are very important. My son calls my father Papa, so that's why I'm saying that. Also, Catherine, hats off to you, darling, because I would not have been that composed. I'm afraid I would not have been that unembarrassed. She was so composed. She was like, oh, what are you trying to do? Trying to slap my face? Trying to punch me out? Sock me out?
But I was hitting you. It was not punching you. Babe, you're not punched.
Whatever you're doing. Okay, that's fine. And it's really good because it came out really good in the footage that she was so controlled with this little boy. And his two siblings are sitting there literally just like, we're not with him. It's adorable. In contrast to how Meghan handled the children when she was like shushing them. Like she thought she should be the one to like shush other people's children. Which, unironically, she should have shown her children at that moment, you know. But in great suspense, we waited. And we have no confirmation that the Queen instead celebrated Lilibet's birthday party. We have no confirmation of that. We do know that she sat with a fake-ass Paddington bear, which was cute. Where was Lilibet's, you know, big ol' reuniting and feels so good. Like, that never happened. I think that was because, in my opinion, the Queen was being very cautious. Like, she wanted to make sure that there was no cameras, there was no Netflix deal, there was no content that was being monetized. And so she'd rather sit with a literal AI Paddington bear, you know? CGI, rather, you know, computer generated image, than show anything that could be utilized by Meghan and Harry. Now, let's get to the photo. So here we have the photo of Meghan and her daughter. Beautiful little girl. I really love redheads. I've said that before in my videos from way back, but I don't know how she got so lucky to get two beautiful redheads like she did.
Okay, and of course there's these conspiracy theories that she color corrected these photos to make her Lilibet appear to have red hair, just to make her look more like Harry. And because there's this other photo which looks like an original where her hair is more blondie brown, but children go through phases. I mean, here she was born with hair that appears to be light brown. But yeah, it's just a conspiracy theory. Also, every time I put out a video, you lovely people here tell me that she's 49, 45, 50. And every time I put out a video, it seems like she gets older. Look, she looks good. I would say she looks about 30 in this photo. So she looks good for her age, whatever it is. We don't know. We'll never know, because with these actresses and Hollywood and their comps and everything, they just lie. They lie about everything. So, you know, we don't know her age. But, yeah, she looks good.
At the same time, you can see with Meghan, her skin is freckly. She has that redhead gene. I think her dad is the one that, well, obviously not her mom, but her dad has the freckle kind of skin and the red hair. As a young man, he would have been a redhead, more or less, or strawberry blonde.
So this is Meghan on the right top, Harry on the left top, and Lilibet on the bottom. And you can see the nose, the Markle nose.
I hope he has my nose, because then every time they see Archie, they're going to see me.
I don't think Lilibet has the Markle nose, thanks be to God. But yeah, she's cute. They're all cute as babies. They're all cute.
The genetics is so interesting with mixtures. I think Thomas Markle talked about the Markle nose. I don't know why she does everything upside down and the wrong way around and whatever. But anyway, eventually she came forward and she gave us a picture. Not to overshadow the queen, of course. No, she never thinks about doing things like that. But yeah, I just wanted to say I am here. I am so happy that this Jubilee was so interesting to me. I love so much of it. We had our own party. It was great. It was barbecue. It was coronation chicken. It was also mixed with a lot of colonial dishes from the Caribbean.
I'm the queen! Who are you?
Van Dyke.
Van Dyke? That's a lovely name.
I said Valentine.
Oh, Valentine. Lovely. Even better.
Very good. And it was really wonderful and we loved it very much. My hairstyle though is a work in progress. I'm doing the Bantu knots. But I did them small before and now I'm doing them bigger. I don't know if you want to see the back. Let me show you the back of it. I mean, it's not perfect. I'm working on it though and it will be perfected soon enough. Okay, thank you so much for watching me. I'm sorry, I'm so excited. I'm still like on a high from the entire Jubilee and all the activities that were involved in that. And also here in Jersey, where we did a lot. We celebrated. There were roads blocked off, but we did our part and I'm very happy about that. And thank you very much for watching me. Love you. I love you. Bye.